It's time for another Ask Game Dev Game Engine Showcase. In this edition, we're visiting a game development tool that has been around for quite some time. We're talking about Monogame, the open-source cross-platform game development framework. In our past videos, we've come across Monogame several times. This time, we want to dedicate a full episode to it and see what the devs in the indie scene have created with this awesome tool. We are Ask Game Dev, and these are six awesome 2D games made with Monogame. Welcome back. We make videos on how to elevate your game development and inspire others. If after watching this video you want to continue the game dev conversation, check the video description for a link to our Discord server. We're now making fresh Ask Game Dev content on all of the major social networks, so be sure to check us out there too. Before we get to the games, let's take a glance at the story behind Monogame and its capabilities. Created in 2009 by José Antonio Leal de Farias, Monogame is a game development framework built as an evolution of the Microsoft XNA Application Programming Interface, or API. XNA is a freeware development library distributed by Microsoft aimed at developers that want to access a lightweight version of DirectX to create games in a versatile yet simple way. At launch, Monogame only supported development for iOS games. Later on in 2011, Monogame was published on GitHub as a free and open source framework for creating powerful cross-platform games. Since then, Monogame has seen nothing but growth. It currently supports a wide variety of platforms, including iOS, macOS, Android, Linux, Windows platforms, PlayStation 4, PlayStation Vita, Xbox One, Nintendo Switch, and more. Written in C#, Monogame features 2D and 3D rendering capabilities, a well-designed interface with library explorers, sound playback, math solutions for games, and more. Monogame has become a very popular development tool within the indie scene due to its great versatility. Keep in mind, this means there's a lot of coding to do with Monogame, so it's best suited for those who want to or are already delving into the universe of programming. Being a spiritual successor of XNA, devs that are familiar with Microsoft frameworks and libraries may have a better time easing into this tool. XNA was discontinued in 2013, but it lived on through Monogame and other frameworks. Another XNA re-implementation that is popular amongst indie devs is FNA. FNA aims to reproduce XNA as it was made by Microsoft. If you want to check it out too, we'll leave a link in the description below. We'll also leave a link to Monogame's GitHub repository, where you can download, tweak, transform, and repurpose this free and open source software to your liking. Now, without further ado, let's see our first game made with Monogame. First up, we have Streets of Rage 4 from .mu, Lizard Cube, and Guard Crush Games. This game is the resurrection of the 90s Streets of Rage franchise. Relive the thrill of these 2D beat-em-up adventures in an all-new experience pumped up with beautiful hand-drawn art and animations, some sick 90s-inspired tunes, and an overload of braised chicken. For some extra nostalgia trip, you'll also be able to unlock classic character sprites and soundtracks from the original trilogy. Lizard Cube artist Ben Fiquet was inspired upon completing Wonder Boy: The Dragon's Trap, a 2017 remake of 1989's Wonder Boy 3: The Dragon's Trap, and set his mind on doing a remake of the Streets of Rage saga. With the help of the .mu studio, they approached Sega on this matter and the idea turned into a full sequel to the series instead of a remaster. .mu was given the license to publish Streets of Rage 4, and they teamed up with Lizard Cube and Guard Crush Games to develop it. The latter designed a custom game engine called Guard Crush Engine using bits and pieces from several libraries and frameworks, including Dear Imgui by Okurna, Monogame, FNA, Protobuf-Net by Mark Gravel, and WWISE by AudioKinetic. This engine was fully packed with every feature they needed to develop their game. This was all possible thanks to an XNA-based engine they had previously created for the indie gem Streets of Fury X, an awesome Streets of Rage homage where the sprites are made out of real-life photos a la Mortal Kombat. Streets of Rage 4 was released in April 2020 and received a gold medal from Famitsu shortly after. By April 2021, a year later, the game had already sold 2.5 million copies. It is now sitting with a 92% very positive review on Steam. You can also pick up the game on Nintendo Switch, PS4, and Xbox One. If you want a physical copy, you'll find several links on their website to retailers that sell them. If you're lucky, you can even snag a Japanese physical copy of the game. Based in Maryland, USA, next up is the game development studio BitKid with their Kickstarter success, Chasm. Chasm is a Metroidvania 2D pixel side-scroller that features a mesmerizing procedural underground world tucked beneath a remote mountain town. Explore the cave systems and unlock abilities that will help you delve deeper and deeper into areas within the mountain, with each area even more eye-catching and filled with secrets than the previous one. The devs of Chasm worked on the title for 6 years before their release in 2018. BitKid, formerly known as Discord Games, started developing games in 2011 as a side hobby, using Microsoft's XNA. In 2013, they started using Monogame. That same year, then went to GDC and tried to pitch Chasm to several publishers. Unfortunately, they had no luck. Things were about to turn around, though, as they went on to launch a Kickstarter campaign. When all was said and done, they ended up raising $191,897. Cruising past their original campaign goal of $150,000. According to the devs at BitKid, Monogame was a great step from XNA due to it being OpenGL, giving them much more cross-platform capabilities than before. Along with their development, they started to include SDL2 and FNA into their workflow to make graphic, sound, and input improvements. Chasm is available for Windows, Mac, Linux, Nintendo Switch, PS4, and Xbox One. Check out their website at chasmgame.com for links to all the storefronts. From the same studio that gave life to the mega hit Hades comes Bastion. Bastion was the first game developed by Supergiant Games, a team of 7 people, in their early days. The game features a beautiful 2D isometric world shattered by a surreal catastrophe called the Calamity. Hack and slash your way in this action RPG adventure with its reactive narrator who marks every decision and move you make. The development of Bastion began in September 2009. Gavin Simon, one of the team's programmers, designed a custom engine based on the XNA framework. All the project was self-funded and took about 2 years, with the game releasing in July 2011 for Xbox Live Arcade and August 2011 for Windows. For more on this, check out Giant Bomb's coverage on the game's development. It's a great resource for anyone interested in their process. We'll leave a link in the description below. Bastion is an outstanding example of what a studio's debut game should be. It's an experience that exudes creativity every second of gameplay.
The entire game drips with passionate artistry, from the gorgeous watercolor aesthetics to the stirring soundtrack,
wrote Wired in their article about Bastion. Additionally, the game currently boasts a plaque on Steam, 100+ industry awards. Among these are several Best Downloadable Game and Best Indie Game awards. After their success with Bastion, Supergiant Games included Monogame in their workflow in order to ship versions of the game for Mac, Linux, PS4, Vita, Xbox One, Nintendo Switch, and more. They even made their custom version of Monogame available as open-source software to anyone who wants to download it. We'll leave a link in the description below for you to check it out. We'll also leave a link to Bastion's website, where it's available now on Steam, the App Store, the Xbox Store, Nintendo eShop, and the PlayStation Store. Now, let's revisit a game that was previously featured in our Best Solo-Developed Games video. We're talking about Axiom Verge by Thomas Happ, a Metroidvania 2D retro side-scroller set in a mind-bending alien world. Play as the scientist Trace, who, after a lab accident, wakes up in a strange and dangerous place, not really sure if he's in a distant planet, the far future, or a complex virtual reality computer simulation. The title's solo developer, Thomas Happ, used to draw and sketch when he was relaxing at home after work. He tried to imagine the best NES game. What would the story be? How would the art look like? What characters, items, and power-ups would it have? Combining elements from his favorite games like Contra, Metroid, Blaster Master, Bionic Commando, and others, all of this fantasizing started to morph into the concept that became Axiom Verge. The first version of the game was developed in Monogame and released for PlayStation 4 in early 2015, after nearly 5 years in development. Thomas worked on every detail there is to his game, including art, music, and coding. After launch, he received some great help from the Monogame team to port the game to nearly every platform out there, including Xbox One, Nintendo Wii U, Nintendo Switch, PlayStation Vita, Windows, and Linux. Axiom Verge is truly one of the best solo-developed games out there. The fact that only one person has put so much into a game is a big reason to play it. Axiom Verge has also received a ton of industry recognition, accumulating accolades like GameSpot's Best of E3, Alloy 7's Game of the Year, and more. If you want to get Axiom Verge, you can find links to all its storefronts at axiomverge.com. A sequel to the game, Axiom Verge 2, recently released for Nintendo Switch, PlayStation 4, and the Epic Games Store. You can check it out at axiomverge2.com. Speaking of solo-developed wonders, our next entry is Stardew Valley by Concerned Abe. Stardew Valley is one of those games that needs no introduction, but here's one anyway. Inspired by his nostalgia for Harvest Moon, Eric Baroni set himself to develop the ultimate farming experience. This dream inspired him, under the name of Concerned Ape, to create one of the most immersive 2D top-down worlds ever created in the history of video games. The game was released in 2016, and 5 years later, Eric keeps pushing updates filled with new and fun stuff to do. The latest content update, Stardew Valley 1.5, adds new people, quests, plants, objects, farm layouts, mechanics, and fish tanks. When he decided to start working on his dream game, Eric wrote a custom engine for Stardew Valley in C#, making use of the XNA framework. He self-imposed himself to work 10 hours a day for 4 years. During this process, he remade the game from scratch several times until he got exactly what he wanted. Developing this game changed Eric's life forever. He found in it a project worth pouring all of his time into. Furthermore, he inspired other devs to get into solo game development and follow in his footsteps. In 2017, it was announced that Stardew Valley's revenue was over $30 million across PC, Xbox One, and PlayStation. The following years have brought even more fame to the game, as it was released on Android, iOS, and Nintendo Switch. In one of our past videos, we featured an assessment of how much revenue Stardew Valley has produced for Concerned Abe and his publisher, Chucklefish. Click the card above to learn more. According to Eric Baroni, the Windows version was developed using the XNA framework, but he implemented Monogame to port the game and update the game for other platforms. Not long ago, in August 2021, he announced the 32-bit XNA framework would be replaced with a 64-bit Monogame framework with the update 1.5.5 of the game. Stardew Valley currently sits with an impressive 97% overwhelmingly positive rating on Steam. You can get it there and practically every other modern platform right now. You can check out stardewvalley.net to learn more about where to buy it. Remember that game that was originally born in Pico 8 and then was remade into its final form, turning into one of the top indie hits of the decade? Well, Monogame was involved in its development as well. Our next game is Celeste by XOK Games. The idea was born from a simple, clever, and beautiful minigame made in Pico 8, a virtual fantasy console for developing and playing 128x128 16-color games. We made a whole video about it not long ago. Click the card above if you want to check it out. After almost 3 years of remote work, the game was released in January 2018. According to Noel Berry, Celeste was developed using XNA for its Windows version. Then, FNA was implemented for its macOS and Linux versions and Monogame for its Xbox One, PS4, and Switch versions. Their game caught fire within the indie community due to its captivating story about self-discovery, its beautiful art, and its tough-as-nails gameplay mechanics. Celeste sold over 500,000 copies during its first year alone. This success made it possible for the team to gather up in Vancouver, Canada, and materialize XOK Games. We really appreciate Celeste and keep coming back to it in our videos. We can't wait to see more from XOK Games. Earlier this year, they teased the development of Earthblade, their upcoming title. It has no release date yet, but in the meantime, you can check Celeste's website to get it for Switch, PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and the different PC storefronts that include versions for Windows, Mac, and Linux. If you go to their itch.io site, you can even select between XNA or FNA versions of the game. We'll leave links in the description below. Thanks for watching. For more Ask Game Dev, check out this Game Engine Showcase video or this video on solo game development.